Oh, hello. Hey, it's me again, Saul, whom you know as Paul. Well, let me explain about my name, actually. You remember last time the church gathered together in Antioch, because Barnabas and I were there teaching and preaching people. The church was growing, and in a time of worship, God said, I want you to set apart Barnabas and Saul to go out into the wider world to tell others about Jesus so they too can become followers of Jesus. And we thought, since we were going out into the wider world, I should be known by my Roman and Greek name, which is Paul. And so I became known as Paul, because that's the kind of name familiar among Romans and Greeks, among the Gentiles of the wider world. Well, anyway, the church sent us off, and John Mark accompanied us, and we sailed to Cyprus. Cyprus is actually where Barnabas was from. We were there for a while. We told the people on Cyprus about Jesus. Many of them became followers of Jesus, including the leading government official. Well, that went well, and we left. We sailed north and landed in Asia Minor, and it's at that point that John Mark decided to go back home to Jerusalem. So he left us. And I got a little angry at John Mark, but Barnabas and I carried on. We came to a place called Antioch. We were there for a while. Many people became followers of Jesus there. Others didn't like us and made it where we had to leave. So we left Antioch. We traveled on to several cities, and one of those was named Lystra. Now, in Lystra, the people there didn't even believe in God. They believed in all kinds of superstition. They had all these idols that they worshipped. And Barnabas and I were traveling around Lystra telling people about who God is, about the true and living God. We met a man that was crippled, or he couldn't walk from birth. You know, his whole life he couldn't walk. He just had to beg. And we saw him. He was listening to us, and he was believing in God. And I looked at this man. I said, stand up and walk. And you know what he did? He stood up. And he walked. He walked around everywhere, and he was praising God, and he was attracting a crowd of people, and the crowd came around. They saw what had happened, and someone in the crowd says, hey, guess what? The gods have come down in human form, and these two people here, they were talking about Barnabas and myself. And they said, we need to worship these gods. We need to sacrifice to these gods. And so they started bringing animals to sacrifice to us. And that got me all upset. So I said, wait a second, stop. We're not gods. We're human beings just like you. We came here to tell you about the true and living God, the only one that you need to worship, not these other gods that are made by human hands. The God that we are talking about is the creator of heaven and earth. He's the one who sends the rain to make the grass green, the crops grow so that you can eat and enjoy life. He's the one that you should listen to. He's the one that you should obey. He's the one that you should believe in. And some people believed our message. They became followers of Jesus, but the crowd got all upset and they got angry that we weren't what they thought we were. And so they drug me outside the city and they stoned me. And they thought that I was going to die, and they left me there. Well, after a while, some of those who believed in Jesus, the Christians, came out and they took care of me. And I got up and they brought me back to the city, and I revived and I got better. And after a while, they sent Barnabas and I on. And we went to another city, the Derby, Iconium, and then we went back again to encourage the churches, and Barnabas, you know, his name means son of encouragement. That's what he did. He encouraged them and says, you got to remain true to Jesus, even when people don't like it. You got to stay strong in Jesus. And that's the message we took, and so we did that in all the places we went. We got back in the boat and sailed back to Antioch. When we got to Antioch there, we gathered the church together, the people of God, and we told them all the things that had happened to us, the good and the bad, and that how that many people were becoming followers of Jesus, and that God's people were growing more and more, and the church just praised God, the church worshiped God, and we just praised God. It was a great time together. Well, and before I go, I've one thing I want to leave with you, one thing I want you to remember. Remember back in Lystra, when this big crowd gathered together, and then as a crowd, they kind of got all angry, and they dragged me out of the city and stoned me. Remember that? Well, this is the lesson I want you to remember, is that don't follow the crowd. Don't listen to the crowd, because that can lead to bad things. You need to learn to follow God, listen to God, think, and learn to listen to God, because what God says is right. And when we do what God says, we do what is right. So that's the lesson I want to leave you with. Just don't follow the crowd. Think, listen to God, and follow Him. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.